this is Oregon 6. I've just picked up a load of dry dairy products. It's Sweet Whey. Bags of it, 43,000 pounds. And this road was a tricky road when I was empty, and now I've got a heavy weight. Very beautiful, picturesque, and scenic. But, yeah, it's interesting. I wouldn't come here in the winter, that's for sure. Just taking my time. Don't want to tip this load. Idaho, so once I get to Portland, I'll pick up 84. Well, I'll pick up 5 first, then 84, and it's pretty much all the way on 84. Not sure where I'll stop tonight. Quite low on hours, I've got about 13 hours, and I don't get a recap until tomorrow night. Even then, it's only 7 hours. However, after that, I get 3 11 hour recaps, so just to have an easier day tomorrow, I think that's what I'll do. I really don't want to do a reset at this point. It's too early in the week, because next week, next Friday, I want to be at home for my home time, and I don't want to run out of hours. It's Wednesday today, and I don't want to run out of hours on Thursday, and I can't get home Friday, so I'm going to avoid taking the 34-hour reset and use the recaps. Just means I take a little bit of a hit with miles tomorrow, but it's worth it. I just want to get home. I was originally going home for this weekend, but it was obvious I was never going to get back in time due to the Labor Day holiday and what have you, so I knocked it back a week to the 15th of September instead of the 8th. Surprisingly enough, I've got nobody behind me right now. I thought I would have a queue of people behind me wanting to get past, saying, "Come on, you big lumbering truck, get the heck out of the way," but nobody's there. This is the easy part, by the way. This is the straight part. You get to relax on this one. It's a little bit further up the road when it gets really, really crazy. And the road is in terrible condition as well. That's another issue here. The road, it's wavy, it rocks you from side to side. And there's loads of bumps that really unsettle you on the curves. Really unsettles the truck, making it a lot harder to steer smoothly around the arcs. Very bumpy in places as well. You'll see. Hopefully I've got enough memory on this phone to make this recording. I should have gotten out my DJI Osmo Pocket, but I forgot. So while we were stuck at that manned traffic stop there, I decided to stick the phone on. It's the next best thing. I've actually got some DJI wireless microphones as well. I should have tried out on this to enhance the sound so we could hear my wonderful voice even better. Yeah, so this is the easy straight bit. It doesn't last much longer. And then we're into the twists and the turns and the lefts and the rights and the ups and the downs and the waving to side to side, getting seasick, and all of that good stuff. Tommy's with me right now, he wants to play, but this is just not a role that I give him any attention whatsoever. tonight, and it'll leave me maybe about 5 hours drive tomorrow. Washington, Oregon, Northern California. Very pretty. Never an easy drive. Lots of ups and downs, lots of up for cops, so you don't get caught speeding. Not that I would ever speed. Not that I would ever break that 55 mile an hour speed limit that California so thoughtfully makes for us truck drivers, so we can just take it easy and watch TV while we're driving, because it's going that slow. It's really kind of thing. How they so thoughtfully have about 50% at least. No, it's probably about 70% when I did my count last time on Earth. The rest areas on I-5 closed down for no reason other than to save money. Thank you, California, you're awesome. Well, I'm about 6 or 7 behind me now. And I'll be flying past at the next passing zone. I just can't push these corners with a load because I end up tipping a truck up. Cost us a fortune to house and to feed, for them to use, bring them out, and it's nice for them to get out of the cells and come out, pick up the litter, and make the place look beautiful. It's a great idea. Well, in Oregon, it's so much nicer looking than Southern California, anyway. Northern California is not as bad. But Southern California, especially around LA, it's a dirty place. Do not pass. Oh, there they are. There's the prisoners right there. South Fork Camp, prison work crew. Good lads. Funny that, just talking about them, and we'll get to them the next corner. The cars have got behind me now. Well, not too bad. 4, 5. Sorry, guys. I know how frustrating it can be, but I'm going as fast as I safely can. video game he likes to play now, the little bugger, which is when we're outside going for a walk, usually after he's done his business, he gets all happy and decides to attack my calf muscles. He'll sneak up on me while I'm walking and lift my calf muscles, and it hurts, the little bugger. That's his new game. And he's so happy, he's so proud of himself when he does it. Look at me, nip, nip, nip. They're not vicious or anyway, he's just playing. We tend to roughhouse quite a lot. Does like the tug of war, we've got like, a lot of toys in here now. We've got 10 toys for him to chew on.
Birds.
Devil's Lake. FK Wilson. there to the right. I don't know if you saw it. Fast forward if you missed it. It wasn't a real bear. Button below because it helps, and I ask you to please catch you later.